I still can't believe I'm taking this tiny miniature shunter and trying to haul these two passenger wagons around the entire map in Derail Valley, but hey, that's what we're doing today. What are you doing, little fellow? You almost got run over. Ah, look at him. Look how cute he is. Little tabby. Aww. Now, unfortunately, there's not too much space in here. This is basically a little box, okay? I'm going to be stuck in this box, this battery-powered box, for several in-game days. Hopefully, I don't go completely insane.
All aboard the EV Express.
It's just the way of the world, isn't it? Put yourself in a little electric box like this, and what do you expect? Just a bunch of lead-acid batteries sitting on two axles, going through the countryside. This thing really does struggle. Once the hills start, you can see it's just trudging along. But it does have quite a bit of torque for its size. It's not going to stop. It's just going to go slowly, that's all. Think a charging station. Is there a charging station in Harbour and Town? This video will be a bust if there's no charging station. Okay. No. It's not happy. Oh, God. Nope. That's not what I want either.
Farewell.
Well, I don't think we'll be seeing that carriage ever again in this video. So goodbye, carriage number three. There she goes, never to return. Now I'm just fooling around. I've decided to leave the cab and just see how fast this thing's actually going in comparison to walking speed. And as you can see, I'm pretty much walking at the same speed as what this thing's currently doing. I must say the weather's been really kind to us so far in this journey. So hopefully the weather holds out. Well, folks, seems like I spoke way too soon there. Looks like we've got all manner of thunder and lightning and rain coming down right now. The Derail Valley weather gods are angry today. Running into some problems here. Looks like we're getting some wheel spin because this got a bit of an incline here that's a little bit unrelenting. And this rain has ruined the rails, made them all wet. Yeah, the wheels are spinning. Let's... Oh no, let's do something about that. The sand. Oh, the sand's doing nothing. No, I think we're gonna stall this train right now. Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. This is Derail Valley Simulator. And get yourselves ready because we are going on one big journey today with this little microshunter. Yes, this is the microshunter that we are looking at right here in Derail Valley Simulator. And this microshunter is a tiny, tiny little battery electric locomotive, isn't it? It's absolutely tiny. Yes, you can see here that it looks very, very out of place. And I've got a few passenger wagons hooked up to it right here. We're actually here in City Southwest in Derail Valley, in the City Southwest area of the map. So that is basically, well, as the name says, in the southwestern region of the map. So I thought I'd do something just a little bit crazy once again today. I have a bit of a habit on my channel of taking some of these locomotives within Derail Valley and taking them for a spin around the map. And I thought, why not do this with the little microshunter as well? And yeah, this is... I don't know how this is going to go today. I guess there's only one way to find out, and that's to give it a red hot go. Now, I have covered this locomotive recently on my channel, very recently, I guess, in my previous video. So check that out, card up above, if you haven't already. I go over all the details of that locomotive, of this locomotive in that video, a bit of a first look. But yes, in this video, what we're looking at here is, well, I've just got the vehicle catalog up right now, and this is a recent addition to the game as well as part of Build 98. This vehicle catalog gives you a whole bunch of important information for each of the different locomotives in the game. And I'm currently looking at the page for this little micro-shunting locomotive, this little battery electric EV locomotive, as it's called, I guess, or as it could be called. You'll see there that the load rating for this thing is not great, okay? So it can pull 800 tons in the dry on the level, but only 100 tons going up hills, and that drops to 50 tons up hills in the wet. So what we've got here is 33 tons times 3. So we've basically got 100 tons behind us today, and it's raining. So basically, this thing's already overloaded as it is, okay? I'm just checking the handbrakes while I yammer on here. But yes, if we encounter any 2% grades right now with this load on the back, we're going to be overloading the locomotive. So, yeah, you can imagine going around this entire map, there's bound to be some 2% grades here and there. And it's bound to be raining now and again as well. It's actually raining right now, if you haven't noticed. So yes, it's going to be an interesting run. So what I'm going to do is take this thing, as mentioned, from City Southwest, and we're going to go for a nice little spin around the map today. I guess you'll have to get yourself some snacks and some drinks and get yourselves all comfortable, because this is going to be one heck of a ride indeed. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just put the map down and just do a little bit more of an overview as to the actual routes I'll be taking in this video. It's going to span multiple in-game days, so I'll divide it up into chapters based on the day. Starting here, City Southwest, what I'm planning to do is head in an easterly, well, a southerly direction first, come down to Sawmill, then head east across, all the way across to Harbour and Town. Okay. And from there we're going to be going uphill. There's some crazy hills around here. Hopefully it's not raining at that time, and we're going to continue our way. Now at this point it's going to be a bit of a decision point, depending on our battery charge. Either hang a left or continue straight up to Iron Ore Mine East and then come across this way. I'm kind of two minds about it at the moment. I'm thinking probably go left, take loop-de-loop. Our final target here, well, our target is to get to Food Factory in Town anyway, and then from there continue to Iron Ore Mine West, come down to Machine Factory, and then basically from there return back to where we are right now, which is a City Southwest. Okay, so let's get all comfortable here. Just going to put the map down. Now, unfortunately, there's not too much space in here. This is basically a little box, okay? I'm going to be stuck in this box, this battery-powered box, for several in-game days, so it's going to be very, very interesting indeed. I don't know how I'm going to do it. Hopefully I don't go completely insane, and there's not much space to put all my wares down either, so I'm going to just do some shifting around on my inventory here. But the idea is to have some of the quick items like the flashlight, the pocket watch, wallet, all that kind of stuff at hand, so within easy access. So unfortunately, there's no wipers on this thing, and it's obviously raining right now. So I'm going to have to probably open the window for some of the trip, just to get a clearer view. You can see here we've got a nice full battery charge on the old batteries. This thing has 100 something volt lead acid batteries, basically, all throughout. So the biggest problem, I think, is going to be range as well. So hopefully we don't run out of juice, because there's quite a hefty load behind us, I must say. I mean, three passenger wagons, 100 ton. We do have our end of train marker as well, which is good. But yes, I'm hoping that I won't have to drop a wagon along the way if the battery consumption really gets hit. We'll just have to see how we go. Hopefully we end up with at least, I don't know, two passenger wagons. If we can keep three of them, that'd be great. But I don't know if that's going to be possible. So, yeah, anyway, that's remains to be seen. Just going to have to see how we go, I guess. So what I'm going to do right here is we've got the electrics on, the traction motor breaker, circuit breakers on, cab lights on. I might actually just turn off, actually, got the dial lights. You know what? I'll keep the cab light on for now. Now, the headlight, I'll just go for the front. I am mindful that these things do use electricity, so that's one thing to kind of be wary of. Everything in a battery electric vehicle consumes the battery, all the services like the lights and all that kind of stuff. You don't have some generator producing electricity. So yes, just have a look at the side of this thing as well, just quickly. You can see how it's fairly symmetrical back and front, but there's only a door on one side. But it's pretty cool how they've set the control panel up so that you're kind of standing sideways. And you can basically like control this thing, and you can move it back and forth. You can go forward or back, and it's, you know, you're basically, it's a reversible kind of design, I guess you could say. So it doesn't really matter which way we go. There's no real forward or backwards, but yeah. Anyway, I've moved the reverser there into forward, I guess you could call it, and just sound the horn there, which sounds like a little car. But anyway, right, make sure the brakes are off. Let's get a little bit of power on. Now it is raining, so we do need to be careful here that we don't spin the wheels. And you can see the ammeter there, we're doing over 100 amps, so we're really We are really putting on the power right now, whatever power this little thing has. There we go. We'll just open this window just a little bit. And I love how you can actually close it down just slightly, but still keep it open. Just get a little bit of air in. If the rain gets worse, I may have to just open the window completely. But yeah, it's very, very claustrophobic in here, I must say. Especially for a long trip, I'm not sure how we're going to go. There's no seats or anything to sit. And basically just standing the entire time. I guess, yeah, I'm not playing this in VR mode, but if I was, it'd be a heck of a play because you'd be standing the entire time. anyway. Alright, I've decided to open the window. So what we're going to do is we're going to come across here. We need to turn right soon and then make our way south. Okay, so there's a set of points just up ahead here. And we'll be encountering them soon. We are basically still obviously within City Southwest here. We're just making our way through the yard. It's going to be very interesting to see how we go on today's trip because this is a vehicle that is designated as an emergency tow vehicle, okay? It's not made to do these long trips. It's not designed for what I'm using it for at all, okay? This is meant to be just an emergency vehicle and I'm using it to tow passenger wagons all around the map. So, hooray to me. If I can pull this off, I think it'll be a really good kind of... well, it'll really show just how versatile this little micro shunter is, I guess. And there it is right there. We're going around the map in the micro shunter in Derail Valley. Am I crazy? Yes, I am. Will I make it? I have no idea. But right now, we seem to be going okay. We'll just have to see how long this lasts. I can see that the passenger wagons are just pushing this thing along as well. It's kind of skewing the vehicle, it seems, on the curves, which is interesting. Hopefully we don't derail. Well, so far we're making some good speed. We're doing about 20k an hour there. I'm just gonna put some of these items down. We're going to need the comms radio in just a moment, actually, because we're going to have to potentially change those points so that we can head off to the right-hand side and head south down here to Sawmill. And we'll just see which way those points are set. Yep, we're going to need to change them. Let's just do that now. Alrighty. Now, we've got our first challenge coming up. We've got a bit of an incline as we head over to the right-hand side here. And actually, it's only a 20k an hour limit around this curve, because this curve coming up right here, it's actually a little bit sharp, and it's only 0.5%, so as long as it's not more than 2%, we're okay with this load that we've got behind us. But the moment it goes to 2%, we are gonna start running into trouble, because the load limit for this is 50 ton going up a hill in the rain. So actually, is that wheel spin I just heard? Okay, speed limit's gone up to 30, but there's no way we're going to do that in this little thing. Oh no. Okay. Well, so far it's doing okay. Depending on how we go with battery, I may well turn the headlight off as well soon. Just see how we go, I guess. Doing okay so far. Okay, you can probably hear the difference in the electric motor whine there. Oh, it really is slowing down because, we are going up a bit of an incline. And as it slows down, those amps will increase. And then the traction motor temperature, I'm guessing, will start to increase as well. And the thing with this as well, just like in the other electric locomotives within the game, or the diesel electrics, I guess, if you put too much load on the motors, they will overheat and can, I guess, blow a traction motor breaker and potentially cause damage as well. So it's not all about just going full throttle the entire way. You've got to be careful not to overload this thing as well. So that's going to be a little bit interesting, I think. Yeah, she's really starting to struggle now, coming down to about 10k an hour. We're doing 100 amps, so running like this is going to chew into the battery as well. So that's another thing to just be mindful of also. We'll just have to see how it goes. This is only a 0.8%, I think it was, or less than 1%, I believe, incline. And it is raining. So far, no wheel slip, though. As we get ever closer to City Southwest. Sorry, Sawmill. We've left City Southwest, kinda. It's still on our right-hand side there, but... we're only just on the outskirts of City Southwest. We still have quite a little ways to go before we get to our first stop of Sawmill. Okay. Yeah, I'd really love to just put these things down. They should have really put a little bit more storage space in this thing. There's no proper, like, table surface or anything like that to put these things on. And, I mean, you can... There are physics as well, so the map is affected by physics, as you can see. Ooh, it's gonna fall, it's gonna fall! Okay, didn't fall. I think it got caught on that little reversing lever. But yeah, there's not really much space to put things down, so things are gonna get kind of obstructed. The gauges and the warning panel. Who needs the warning panel? It's fine, right? it's gonna be slow going, I think, this trip. So, yeah, I mean, so far it's not doing too badly. We are making a bit of progress here as we head on towards our first stop there, Sawmill. And temperatures are in check. We're doing 100 amps. Ooh, okay, look at that. The battery, that battery consumption there is really come down a bit. That's a little bit concerning. I haven't seen it drop that fast like that before. Okay, well, it's gonna be interesting, you know, if we can't make it to Harbour and Town because we've run out of juice, then it's all over Red Rover, I guess. But we'll just have to see how it goes. Keep an eye on that consumption. If need be, I can start turning off the headlights and other lights and try and save a bit of juice that way. That's probably not gonna make too much difference, but we'll see. Now tell me, is this the wave of the future, traveling like this in a little electric box? We could just run out of battery power at any moment and then we'll be stuck here. There's not even enough room to kind of jump in here. My head just kind of clips through the roof slightly. okay, still pulling 100 amps. It's well and truly just after midday now. We did get started around 9 a.m. in the morning. I didn't show the watch in the beginning, but it was about somewhere between 8 and 9 a.m. And yeah, it's just after lunchtime now, and we're still on the way to our first stop being the Sawmill. So we'll just have to keep on trudging here. I know this is not the most thrilling kind of train to be using for this, but at the same time, I just want to see just what kind of range we can get with this little micro shunter, and hopefully it's a bit of an exercise in experimentation and research for all of you to just see what this thing is capable of when it comes to long range travel. Because I mean, this thing is an emergency tow vehicle after all, so the whole purpose of it is to be able to tow some vehicles or carriages over distances. So you can see there, we're about halfway to Sawmill right now on the map, and we're still doing about 10k an hour and doing 100 amps. So yeah, it's just going to be more of this for a little bit, I guess. And depending on how many more hills we encounter, it's really going to take a big chunk of juice out of our battery. So I'm really looking forward to once we start to hit the downhill sections. That's when we can pick up a bit of speed. I can get off the throttle a bit and save some of that juice, because I'm a bit concerned as to how much battery we're consuming right now, but I know that's not going to last forever. I think the run to Sawmill is mostly level, the way we're going now, but there are some 0.8% grades which we are encountering along the way here, so that's why things are going a little bit slow right now, but they should be increasing. Things should be improving shortly. Actually, I can already hear the speed picking up, so it sounds like we might be on a level grade now, thankfully. So we'll keep on going. Maybe that was short-lived. You can really tell the motor whine just gives it away straight away as this thing picks up speed. Now this thing, I've read that if you get it to about 45k an hour, you will blow apart the electric motors. So as we go down hills, we do need to be careful as well that we don't go too fast, and we may need to actually brake a little bit, because past 45 k's an hour, which is not even indicated on the gauge there, the speedo, yeah, it's every man for himself, or every woman for themselves, for herself. Yes, 40k an hour limit. Not doing that anytime soon, that's for sure. It's just going to be a nice little old journey today, isn't it? Look at that. And we're getting into the fun section of the ammeter there. So we're going to start generating a bit of heat shortly, I think.
All aboard the EV Express.
You'll be waiting a while, but you'll get there, maybe, if you don't run out of batteries. Okay, I'll stop bashing this little thing. It's for all of what it does and what it doesn't do, I think overall, it's not doing too badly considering it's basically just a pile of batteries and two electric motors on a set of wheels. And really, that's all it is, so... Yeah, I'm glad the weather's cleared up as well. No more rain for the moment, which is good. Hopefully this keeps up for the majority of the trip, because if we encounter rain coming out of harbour and town, going up the plus 2% grades there, we won't be able to pull three wagons like we are behind us at the moment. So I'm going to have to drop one of these carriages, I think, soon, potentially, as well, just depending on how we're going battery consumption-wise. So... yeah, we're still just over halfway to Sawmill there. There is a bit of a hill coming up as we approach Sawmill. And then we've got, yeah, more hills along the way here as well. And then, yeah, basically we've got more hills here. And then I think we've got a bit of a hill there as well, or downhill. I think this section here is level, and then downhill to Harbour and Town. So at least we've got that going for us. But yeah, we've got uphills going out of Harbour and Town. Yeah, I don't know. It's hard to say. It's anyone's guess as to how we'll go battery-wise, I guess, at the moment. We'll just have to keep an eye on that battery gauge and just see how we go, because really, we are in... yeah, okay, we're rapidly approaching the three-quarter mark on the battery, actually. So let's just reduce the throttle there a little bit. See... actually, if I turn off the headlight as well, that's going to help. Yeah, we're slowing down too much. We're going to need full throttle, I think, the entire way. at least while we're on these uphill sections. And it doesn't look like uphill, but they're very slight inclines. Like 0.8% or whatever it is, so... yes, it's just the way of the world, isn't it? Put yourself in a little electric box like this. And what do you expect? Just a bunch of lead-acid batteries sitting on two axles going through the countryside. And that's really all there is to say about this thing. There's not much else to it, really. We are getting closer to Sawmill now though, so it won't be too much longer and we'll actually be there. So that's good. And yeah, we'll do a bit of a stop at Sawmill, stretch the old legs, and just do a bit of a inventory on the battery. It's definitely taken a hit, the battery, in this first leg to Sawmill, but I'm hoping that once we pass Sawmill and start making our way east along the map, the bottom of the map there, There's going to be some level sections and even some downhill sections coming out of Sawmill, so we should be reducing our battery consumption a little bit there. We're still just over 3/4, so battery wise we're not doing too badly, but we do just need to keep an eye on that. So yeah, see how it goes. But I can see Sawmill just in the distance here. We're just rounding that final corner and we'll be there very shortly now. Okay, so here's Sawmill. I've just changed the points ahead of us. I'm planning to kind of pull in there to that little servicing bay where there's a little turntable and whatnot. And I'm hoping that there's a charging station, but somehow, having a look at this further, I don't think there actually is a charging station there. So that's actually going to put a bit of a damper on my plans, because I was hoping to charge it pretty much every stop. Even though I probably don't need to. But yeah, it doesn't look like we have a charging post here. So that is a little bit annoying, I think. And I can see a little steam shunter there in the distance as well. But I think, yeah, this might be a bust, this bit here. There is no charging station, so that's a little bit of a worry. Not every station has a charging post, so we're not going to be able to charge this thing up. We're just going to have to keep on going. At this rate, probably looking at getting a charge up only at Harbour and Town, which is quite a distance away still. So yeah, that's going to be interesting. So back we go for the moment. And I'm just going to pull through into Sawmill, into the greater yard section, and we'll just pause and then have a bit of a stop and plan our route from here, I guess. Okay, now getting moving on this hill is going to be a little bit interesting. So let's supply a bit of power and got a bit of a wheel spin there. Come on, 100 amps, 150 amps, 200 amps. She's really struggling to move this these three carriages. Thought I'd show this just to see just how much difficulty it's having going up a hill like this from a standstill. But anyway, I'll catch you shortly in Sawmill. So here we are, arrived at Sawmill, and just stretching the legs for a little bit. Not going to hang around here for too long. Basically, we are down to just above the 3/4 mark on the old battery level. And after this, as we head out of here, I'm still going to keep the three wagons on the back. I'm not going to drop one, although I might regret that a bit later. But for the moment, we've got a nice downhill section. We're actually right on the 3/4 mark, I should say, battery wise. And so next up, we're going to be making our way eastward along the map. I'm not sure if I'll stop at Forest South. I think we'll just make a straight run to Harbour and Town, because if Forest South is anything like Sawmill, where we are right now, there's not going to be a charging station there anyway. And from memory, there's a pretty harsh 2.4% hill, I think it is, going up to Forest South. So yeah, just going to get moving now and head on out of here. Not going to waste too much time, because we've got a long road ahead of us still. So thankfully the weather's holding up, so that's good. So yeah, we've got a bit of a downhill section in front of us, so let's just keep it going. And we should be able to pick up a bit of speed now, so we'll give it full throttle and get this thing moving. And once we get up to a bit of speed, I should be able to get off the throttle and just let this thing coast for a little while and save ourselves some battery, hopefully. So yeah, I can feel it already picking up speed, so that's good. Right, here we go. So just leaving Sawmill, and looks like it's coming up to about 5 p.m. there. So I think it's going to be well and truly dark by the time we hit Harbour and Town. I'm thinking, because I don't really like driving at night time, I may have to make a stop somewhere along the way, probably somewhere around Forest South kind of area. But yeah, that's, we just passed a minus 2.1%, so that's a downhill, a 2.1% downgrade. So I'm just going to get off the throttle, actually, because this thing's picking up speed. I'm just going to reduce the throttle to zero. And you can see there, we are picking up speed, folks, so that is great. In fact, I might need the brake in just a moment as well. I don't want to go too much past about 40, which on the gauge, I think, is the end of the red line. So I've read that at 45, the traction motors can explode. Even without power, they'll just rotate themselves into a big mess. So Yeah, I don't want to let that needle go resting up against the end of that red zone, which it pretty much is now. So I'm going to put some brake on. Got the brakes on. Whoa, we're flying now. Yep, okay. All right. Yep, let's keep that speed in check. The good news is we're not using any, well, very little power right now because we've got just a few lights and bits and pieces on, but we're not using our motors. So that's good. I'm hoping that this is going to save quite a bit of our battery as we go. So that's good. That's good. Just preserve our momentum. I don't want to... I'll try and keep it above 30 and just keep it in the red zone, I guess. Now, unfortunately, if I turn off the electrics, it looks like the speedometer stops working as well. So that is the ultimate in saving power. But unfortunately, I'd like to be able to see the speed. Otherwise, yeah, I could be blowing up the electric motors without realizing. So yeah, we'll keep the electrics running, but we'll just turn off the cabin lights and things like that, headlights, whatever, just to try and save a bit of power. I love cruising through the countryside in this thing, especially when the gravity is working in our favor. This thing really loves to coast along quite well when everything's going its way. And yeah, making some good progress right now. All is well for the moment. Okay, unfortunately I've had to put full throttle back on because now we've hit a bit of an uphill section, unfortunately, as we get closer to the junction just before Forest South. We're not quite at Forest South yet, but we will be there soon, hopefully, if we can keep this thing moving, that is. Yeah, I didn't realize actually, even with just the three carriages on the back at 99 odd ton, whatever it is, this thing really does struggle even in the dry. I mean, it is rated for 100 ton up a 2% grade in the dry. So yeah, we're gonna encounter quite a few 1-2% grades. So I don't know, I'm starting to think now, and this is the beginning of my thought process in this regard, that yeah, seeing as how much battery we are chewing up right now as well, I may have to drop a carriage soon and just go down to two wagons. So yeah, I don't know, that might be something that we need to do. I've got all the lights off, so I'm just using the torch here to show where I am. You can see there I'm still not quite at Forest South, kind of just at that first sort of junction, and unfortunately we've got a plus 1.8% grade in front of us. Okay, so pretty much at the limit for this thing with the amount of load it's got on the back. So I'm thinking, even though we can pull three carriages, it's going to be slow going. So maybe I will actually drop one carriage soon, especially if it continues going like this, because this is just very slow. And I'm mindful that about half an hour into the video, pretty much into the trip at least, and really we're nowhere near halfway across the map, that's for sure. We're probably under a quarter even. So yeah, we're probably about 20% of the way through the trip. So yeah, I think I'm going to have to drop a wagon soon. I just need to figure out where I'm going to do it. And you can see there, for the first time pretty much, the traction motor temperatures are starting to rise, because we're pulling just over 150 amps now. We're doing a pretty hard pull. So you know, I'm actually thinking as well that we should have dropped a carriage at the sawmill, but oh well, hindsight is a great thing, isn't it? This thing really does struggle. Once the hills start, you can see it's just trudging along. But it does have quite a bit of torque for its size. It's not going to stop. It's just going to go slowly, that's all. Very slowly. Extremely slowly. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to get rid of one of these carriages shortly. I think I'm going to do that very shortly, actually. Probably somewhere around Reginald's garage, which is coming up in just a few minutes. So yes. Looks like more of a grade coming up in front of us as well. So that's great. And yep, traction motor temperatures are rising, getting closer to 80 degrees now. Limit is somewhere around just over 100 degrees there. So yeah, like I said, this thing can do three carriages. It's just going to be a very, very slow kind of slog, I guess. And in the interest of this video as well, trying to make some time, which is a bit laughable with this micro shunter in the grand scheme of things, because it's not meant to be a proper locomotive. So somewhere around this little spur, I think I'm going to drop off the third carriage there and just see how it goes. So we'll do that in just a moment, I think. And the sun's starting to go down now as well. I can see the day is drawing to an end, or the shadows are getting longer. So once I drop that last carriage shortly as well, I think we'll have to try and find a little place to just park up, probably, and just spend the night, I think, because I don't want to drive at night time. The reason being, not just because it's quite hard for you guys and girls to see at night time when I'm driving, it's less fun from a video point of view, but also with this one, with this locomotive at least, it uses headlights, which use the battery, as far as I know, at least as I believe it does in the game that's modeled. So if I can get away with using the minimal amount of lights and things like that on this locomotive during this run, I think I'll save, obviously, the battery and save it for actually driving the train. So yeah, once we drop this third carriage shortly, we'll park up and spend the night, and then we'll make our way into day two, I think. So yeah, it's a bit of a hard slog at the moment, but we'll be at Reginald's garage shortly or nearby, and then I'll look at dropping that last wagon. Okay, so I can pretty much see the switches up ahead for Reginald's garage. I think I'm gonna hop out now, and I'm going to try and drop this last wagon whilst this train is in motion. So yeah, probably not the best time to do this, but I've got a bit of a plan. If I can block off the brake valve on the very end, that should allow me to release that last carriage and make it so that it stops. And yeah, just need to figure out a way to get out up onto the roofs here and make sure we've got our, well, probably don't need our comms radio for this actually, but anyway, we'll just make our way across the roofs here of our train. Just need to drop this last carriage because it's too heavy. The train is too heavy and we cannot have this right now, so we need to get rid of this last carriage. So if I just go ahead and drop down a bit. Whoa. Okay, you'll have to bear with me here. I'm gonna try and do this whilst the train is on the move. Just have to disconnect some of these brake lines and disconnect this last carriage. No, that's, oh, that's not what I want. That's not what I want. Okay, no, it's not happy. It's not happy. Oh god, nope, that's not what I want either. Oh god, no, I'm ruining the wheels on the locomotive here. They're just, the train has ground to a halt. This thing is still trying to drive. Oh, what a mess. Okay, that was a bit of a disaster, folks. We might have caused some permanent damage there to our wheels. Yep, not too sure what's happening now. She's definitely not happy. And there goes our carriage. The last carriage. Somehow. Okay. Alright then. Farewell. Well, I don't think we'll be seeing that carriage ever again in this video. So goodbye, carriage number three. Okay, let's do a little bit of damage control and just see what's going on. There she goes. Never to return. Okay, that's a little bit too much fun, I think you'll agree, for one day. A nice little end to day one there, I think. Okay, so what I did neglect to do was turn off the air at the end of the second carriage. That would have meant that our train could have kept moving and we could have just gracefully dropped carriage number three. But because I didn't do that, we dumped all the air out and then the entire train ground to a halt as well. So anyway, live and learn, I guess, on that, in that regard. Now it's going to be interesting trying to get this train moving once again. We're actually moving backwards now as well, so that's not good. And we had the sand on this entire time as well. Excellent. Okay, mozzies are coming out now as well. It's definitely bedtime, folks. So actually, that got moving a whole lot easier that time with only two carriages behind us. Hopefully we don't have to drop any more. We're just basically lopped off a third of the train just now. So yeah, we're down 33 odd ton, down to about 66 ton or so behind us. So I think that's going to make it a lot easier. At least if it rains and we encounter some 2% hills, we're not going to be in such a we're not going to have such a difficult time anymore, hopefully. So two carriages, I think hopefully it's going to be just the right amount, just to make sure that we keep a bit of speed going, because I want to speed up this thing a bit. We've been going a little bit too slow, you might agree, so far in day one today. So we'll go ahead and just park up in Reginald's garage in that siding just very shortly. I'll pull in, we'll spend the night, and then tomorrow is going to be a brand new day. Hopefully the weather is still clear, and we'll go ahead and hopefully we'll make some better time tomorrow and cover some more distance. So here's hoping for that. Okay, so I just parked up for the night here. Reginald's garage, you can see I've got the flashlight going in the cab. That's what that bright light is shining out the side there of our little micro shunter. Might as well turn that off, actually. That flashlight uses power as well. We'll go ahead and just close up for the night. We've got two carriages. Unfortunately, we did have to drop one today. Hopefully, we don't have to drop any more in this journey. Hopefully, two carriages is that sweet spot that would give us just enough of a challenge and ensure that we can still make some good time and not grind away too slowly either. So anyway, I'm going to call it right here, and I guess I'm just going to be sleeping on the floor in a little ball, because yeah, that's really the only option I've got, isn't it? So yeah, basically today we did make quite a bit of progress in the grand scheme of things. We started off at City Southwest. Let's see, it's just after 9 p.m. Yep, so started off at City Southwest. It's basically 12 hours ago we did that. Came down to Sawmill, came across. We did climb some gnarly hills along the way, and then we ran into some issues right around here. We had to drop that third carriage. And well, I made that decision anyway, because we were just grinding along a little bit too slowly. That third carriage went back somewhere. I don't know where it's ended up. But anyway, yeah, we basically made it to Reginald's garage. So day two, tomorrow in the game. Hopefully we'll be a lot more kind of productive as we'll make our way over to Harbour and Town, and hopefully by the end of tomorrow we'll be at Harbour and Town. We can spend another night there, and yeah, the advantage of spending the night in Harbour and Town is we'll actually have a sofa to sleep on, so, and we won't be in the middle of the wilderness as you can hear right now. So, and you might be wondering as well, we didn't seem to cover that much distance today. As you can see here, we've got a fairly long distance to go still to Harbour and Town, but the advantage here is that we've got a nice set of straights, well, level ground and downhill heading into Harbour and Town tomorrow. So that's going to work in our advantage, and I'm hoping we'll be able to cover a lot more ground tomorrow. Okay, we've just got a few little hills here and there along the way, but nothing like what we experienced today, I think. So anyway, it's getting late now, almost 10 o'clock, so yeah, I'm gonna call it, turn everything off, and catch you all in the morning. Good morning, folks. Day two, beginning of day two, and unfortunately once again the rain has decided to make a return. So it's bright and early, 6:30 right now in the morning, more or less, and we're here at Reginald's garage. So what I'm planning to do is basically reverse out of this siding, and as discussed last night, we'll start our way over to Harbour and Town. So yesterday, obviously, as mentioned, we did make our way down from City Southwest all the way past Sawmill and ended up here. We did have to drop a carriage on the way, so we've lost about 33 odd ton off the train. We're down to about 66 ton now, so two carriages instead of three, and hopefully we don't have to drop any more. Hopefully these two carriages will be a good enough kind of challenge, but still give us a lot of speed. So we'll continue on this morning through the rain. Got a few uphill sections in front of us, but hopefully they're not going to prove too challenging. And yeah, hopefully we're not going to spin too much wheels. You know, hopefully not going to get too much wheel spin as we encounter the hills. But we've got a nice downhill section as we get close to Harbour and Town as well. So I'll just put the map over there, and yeah, we're just around the three-quarter mark on the old battery, and I'm gonna go ahead and just turn the cap light on, and looks like we've got our electrics on, I should say. Reverser, we want to move this thing backwards, I guess you could say, and Looks like it's charging up the brakes there. All happy. Okay, let's just reverse out. Let's open this window just slightly. And we'll begin day two of our journey. I'm just going to back this thing out. And then we'll attempt to move forward and continue our journey on, I guess. Okay, I've just backed out of the Reginald's garage siding. Unfortunately, we're on a bit of a hill here, trying to go back uphill, that is. And this thing is just not stopping right now. I've got wet rails, and the wheels are slipping, and I'm sure we're going to get some wheel spin. Yep, we're getting some wheel spin, all right. Okay. Oh, God. All right. Sand. Nope. I'm going to need to put the brakes on. Even with just two carriages behind us instead of the three, it's still kind of struggling a little bit. But yes, I'm hoping that we can make some better time today because we really need to cover some more ground. We are rapidly approaching the halfway mark on the battery, I realize as well. So no longer at the three quarter mark, that's long gone. We are soon going to be at, we're going to be down to 50% with our battery charge level. And after that, it's basically all downhill. So battery wise, I'm sure the battery will start to deplete under 50% as well, probably give out some reduced performance and all that kind of jazz. So yeah, hopefully we'll encounter some nice level grades, level sections and downhills, but for the moment not really, because it looks like we've got a 1% hill in front of us. So let's get the throttle on full and hope for the best. But yeah, as I've mentioned a few times now, I've only got two carriages on the back now, not three. And it really looks like these carriages are skewing this little shunter, this micro shunter on the tracks as well. It's not aligned, it seems, properly. You can see the body there is kind of skewed off a little bit. Or is that just an illusion? I'm not sure. But yeah, this thing is definitely wider than it is long, wheelbase-wise. But so far, I think as long as we can keep that battery charge in check, we should be okay, even if we have to grind a little bit. But as I've mentioned a few times now, we are going to hit some level grades and some downgrades soon, some level ground, level track. So yeah, looks like it's just coming up to 7:30 in the morning, so nice and early start, and we're making our way up or eastward towards Harbour and Town today. And we'll be passing a junction shortly that will take us to Forest South if we head left. And look at that. Yeah, that definitely doesn't look right. Not sure what's going on there. I think what's happening is the carriages themselves are just pushing this thing. But the wheels themselves look like they're aligned on the track. So yeah, not too sure. Anyway. Okay, we're coming out to that junction that I was just speaking of, and it looks like we're set to go to the right hand side already, so that's nice and handy. Don't have to make any changes there. Running a little bit warm and coming down to just almost 50% on our battery charge there, looking at about 55% or something, I think. Got the throttle on full, we're pulling almost 150 amps, traction mode has warmed up a little bit, but yeah, just imagine if we had an extra carriage, we'd be going even slower right now. So I think two carriages hopefully is the sweet spot here, just to get a bit of speed, or a little bit more speed, I guess. But we'll keep on trudging, and we'll make our way eastward, and then soon we're going to encounter some nice level track and some downhills as well. Looks like we've got a, what's that, 2.2% uphill for the moment though, so hooray for us, I guess. Oh no, yep. We're in for some more trudging, unfortunately. Some more grinding up some more hills, for the moment at least. Yep, we are really struggling right now. I'm hearing some buzzing. I'm not sure what that is, actually. I should hop in. Actually, I think that's the... Yep, we're starting to spin the wheels. Yep, okay. Well, this is a 2.2% grade, so we're gonna have to hit the sand, I think. Oh, 200 amps. This is a hard pull, ladies and gents, from this little micro shunter. But I think we're almost over the hump here because it's going to reduce down to a 1%-ish grade in just a moment. So we'll get off the sand as soon as we can. Okay, and yeah, with that, our battery is coming ever closer down to 50%. Right, excellent. Okay, we're speeding up now, that's great. I'm hoping that now we'll have the opposite problem and we'll have to try and keep the brakes on to stop this thing over speeding. Yep, it definitely sounds like we're speeding up now. So that was the worst of it. Thank goodness for that. If it starts speeding up anymore, I'm going to get off the throttle completely and just let it coast. Because the carriages as well, obviously they weigh around 60 odd ton. They weigh exponentially more than this little shunter, so they're going to push this thing on the downhills quite hard as well. So that's why we'll need to be ready with the brakes. Okay, now it looks like we're going back up another hill. Okay, that was short-lived. More grinding. Grinding, grinding, grinding. Got the sand on as well. So all we can really do is just put the throttle on full. Keep the sand on. Looks like we can do without it now though. No more wheel spin. Actually, the weather is starting to clear as well, as you can see there. Sun's come out, rain stopped. So yep, I think we're picking up speed for real this time. I'm really hoping so, at least. Okay, let's see how we go. Still grinding for the moment, folks. It's been a good few minutes, and yeah, it's been quite uneventful, so not much to really see, just more grinding. But hopefully I hold out hope that we're going to hit some level sections and some downhills soon. I really want to make some more ground today. Just thought I'd show the map as well. We are actually starting to increase speed just a little bit here. So yeah, we can see here that we just passed the junction for Forest South, and we are well and truly on our way eastward now. So we've been making a bit of progress so far this morning, but it has been slow once again. But I think we've got hopefully the worst behind us, and we are starting to accelerate. So woohoo for that. Finally. Okay, I'm going to center the reverser there, and we've done enough damage to our battery. So I'm just going to completely turn off the throttle, and it looks like a 40k an hour limit in front of us. I'm just going to let this thing coast, folks. There's no point in trying to accelerate anymore. Turn off all the unneeded lights and electricity. Don't need it. I'll keep the electrics for the gauges on, and that's basically about it. I'm not even going to run the dial lights because it's bright enough, more or less. And now we can reap the fruits of our labor. The downhill section. Thank goodness for that. All right, no more grinding. It's just going to be a nice, easy run. Hopefully for as long as possible as we head east towards harbour and town. That's beautiful scenery today. The weather's cleared up once again. For the past day or so, it looks like we've just had this bad, like, foul weather in the mornings. But then as the day has gone on in Deerail Valley, in the valley itself, the weather has cleared up, so very thankful for that. It is coming up to about 2 p.m. though, so yeah, we've been kind of grinding for most of the day. Hopefully for most of this afternoon though, we can just keep this pace up, because we have to make harbour in town before it gets too late. I don't want to camp out in the woods again like we did last night. Day 2 is going to be a different story, so still got some time. We'll keep her going, and I'll check in with you again in just a moment, I guess. Problem at the moment, we're running just a little bit too fast, so I'm gonna have to put the brakes on because I don't want to get over 45, and I don't know what indication we are looking at now. But yeah, I'm just bringing it down to what I assume is just under 40. And we are making some good progress, thankfully, through the valley. We'll keep this pace. As you can see there, we're coming up to a little junction, which we'll need to make sure we go right. And then we'll begin our little line of squigglies as we get close to harbour and town. There is a bit of a uphill section, actually, just after this junction. But it's only a 0.6 from what I can see, so... yeah, might need a bit of throttle. We are moving off to the right. I just only checked out just now. That was a bit late. But anyway, yes, there's a bit of a hill here. So we're going to need some throttle, I think, shortly. Actually, it still says it's a downhill, though. It will go uphill shortly, though, as far as I know. But yeah, we'll keep this thing moving. Okay, I'm gonna have to get onto the throttle very shortly, I think. Let's try it now. Put the reverser in forward, that always helps. Yeah, I can hear that motor just whining away. It's really running high revs right now. And I think we're gonna start to slow down in just a sec as well. So, might be encountering a bit of a hill in just a sec. But it's only a 0.6. I'm not sure what that little yellow marker is. Anyone know? Might be where our carriage ended up, maybe. Not too sure. That third carriage. Potentially. Right now, I really don't care. Just got to keep this thing moving. We're back on full throttle, so we're using battery power once again. I just want to try and preserve as much speed as possible. I don't want to slow right down again, because once you slow down, the going just gets really, really slow. And I want to try and keep it above 20k an hour if I can. Anywhere from 20 to around the 40 mark would be perfect. Or anywhere from 30 and above even would be perfect, actually. And 20 and above is ideal. And 10 and below is really not ideal. Okay, we'll see where we end up in just a few moments. See here that we are well and truly below, well, just under the halfway mark on the battery. Thankfully, we are speeding up now once again as we head ever more east, I guess, eastward to Harbour and Town. So I'm happy with this momentum. We'll keep this train moving, and I must say, I think it's good having the two carriages on the back. It's probably just the right amount for this little shunter. Once again, I just want to make sure we keep a good momentum going, because we've still got quite a bit of distance to go around this entire map. Once we get to Harbour and Town, I'll be really happy. That will be a major kind of achievement, I think, for this little micro shunter. We can see there that we're making our way across the bottom of the map. Just turn on the cabin light here briefly. Just going through this rather long tunnel at the moment. So we've got a reducing speed limit coming up soon, but still around 70k an hour in this section of track, so well below the track limits for the most part. Let's just keep the dial lights on, I think, for the moment. The day is getting on, but we're making good progress. I think we're making better progress than yesterday, thankfully. We are speeding down the track in comparison. For the majority, at least, of this trip so far, day two. Ooh, okay, speed's coming up past 40 again. Oh, that could have been up around 45 even, I'm not sure, but... yeah, I don't think it was that far past 40, but, yeah. Don't want to hit 45, because that'll be a big no-no, that one. Or above 45, at least, is, I believe, when the traction motors may begin to just come apart, so obviously don't want that. Okay, so we are making progress. We are making progress. We'll just continue this run through. Just have to babysit the brakes a little bit here and just keep the speed under control. midday, day two, and we are continuing our nice and easy run, just coasting down towards Harbour and Town, barreling our way, and actually kind of getting some nice scary sounds as we go around some of these curves actually. So I kind of got, yep, I'm getting close again. Ooh, okay, that's not good. At the same time, I just want to try and keep this momentum going, so hopefully next time I check in with you, I'll not be in a ditch on the side of the tracks. Just navigating these rather twisty sections of track right now as we get closer to Harbour and Town, but hopefully we'll be through these all shortly. Okay, so we've just gone through those little twisty little turns, and we are making our way ever closer to Harbour and Town there. As you can see, that little blue, that little cyan marker come through those little twisty sections there just now. And I've got the power on once again because we've started to start to slow down again. But yeah, unfortunately I can't capture every single twist and turn on this map as I take this micro shunter around the map, because unfortunately it would end up probably being a 6-hour video. So in the interests of saving everyone's sanity and possibly mine, but that's probably too far gone. just kidding. I'm more worried about you folks than me at this point in time. So yeah, we are making some good progress once again. So yep, battery power is below 50 degrees, sorry, below 50%. And yep, we are keeping the speed up, possibly even slightly too much, but that's good. I just want to see, okay. So yeah, we're down to probably what, 45% battery or something like that, or towards 40% battery, but still heaps of battery when you think about it, because we are almost on the outskirts of Harbour and Town now. So we'll be there very shortly as we continue on barreling our way. And I'm very glad the weather's held out once again. Still fine for the moment. Well, would you look at this, folks? If you would turn your heads over to the right hand side, you will notice that is Harbour and Town. So we have actually made it to Harbour and Town pretty much. We should be there in just only a few minutes now. So if we look at the map here, we can see that we're basically just on the outskirts. Thankfully, it's a nice downhill run all the way into Harbour and Town, as we know. Unfortunately, there's some really, really steep grades coming out the other side, but that's tomorrow's problem. Anyway, we'll spend the night here at Harbour and Town once we arrive shortly. It is the afternoon, so I do want to charge the battery once we get into Harbour and Town. I'm sure there's going to be a charging station there. If there isn't, this video is basically a bust, because yeah, this battery is not going to last for much longer, especially once we tackle those hills out of Harbour and Town. So we're going to need a nice full charge, I think, tonight at the end of day two. And once we do that, we'll be ready to go for our next leg tomorrow, which will be out of Harbour and Town, heading north up towards Food Factory in Town. So yeah, anyway, looks like our speed is really taking a huge dent right now, because it's very possible that we just hit a temporary grade section here, but that's not going to last very long. We'll be over this hump very shortly, and then we'll be barreling down the hill towards Harbour and Town once again. I love these little exterior shots though. The little shunter, look at it. Look how tiny it is. It's just absolutely miniature, isn't it? I still can't believe I'm taking this tiny miniature shunter and trying to haul these two passenger wagons around the entire map in Derail Valley, but hey, that's what we're doing today, and it's actually going a little bit better than I'd hoped. Okay, so here we are. We're basically rolling into Harbour and Town right now, rolling down this famous or infamous little downhill section as we come barreling into Harbour and Town, and I'll get onto the horn very shortly. It's still got our carriages behind us, both of them even. Always handy. I'm gonna hang on to these two. I can't see myself reducing the train anymore, because that would just mean I've got one carriage, and that would be quite sad indeed, I think you'll agree. So first port of call as we enter Harbron Town here is towards our left hand side. As we go around this curve, you'll see that the battery levels depleted a little bit, down to around 40% now. You'll notice that we'll have a little roundhouse section appearing very shortly on our right, and you can actually see already there's a tower in the distance there, just towards the left after those big sheds, after the blue ones, after the grey ones. There's that little tower in the distance there, you might see that. That's actually the servicing area, and what I need to do here is just flip these points leading into that area so that we actually head into there. And there will be hopefully a charger waiting for us in there, because if there isn't, we are basically up the creek with no paddle. So I haven't checked, but I'm assuming there's a EV charging station in there somewhere, probably inside the roundhouse. So yeah, we'll pull in, and we're making good time though. It's around 5 o'clock or so, I think. It's late afternoon anyway, kind of mid to late afternoon. I just want to pull in. Obviously the turntable needs to be aligned. We don't want to keep going too much further, otherwise we'll fall into the turntable hole, which we don't want to do. So I'm going to have to stop here, just hop out, and I'll go ahead and just flip turntable over. Probably disconnect the carriages, leave them where they are, and yeah. We'll go ahead and service this thing, probably load it up with sand, and obviously charge the battery all the way up to the top, because tomorrow, day 3, hopefully we'll be blessed with good weather again. But also, heading out of here, we got some big old hills in front of us, so yeah, we're just gonna head straight in here. There's a, I think, a charging station. Is there a charging station in Harbron Town? Not too sure. This video will be a bust if there's no charging station. Actually quite low on power, we're just under half. And yeah, this thing is doing its strange skewing. Ooh, okay, that's not good. Right, I'm not sure if we can get this train connected after that, because that was there was a lot of stress on that just now, and I've just managed to break the train with quite some violence, so yeah, I shouldn't have disconnected the train like that while it was on a kind of a sharp curve. Let's pull in and charge this thing up, shall we? Okay, so we're here at the charging station, and you can see here wheels have taken a bit of damage so far. I've done a bit of wheel slipping in these last 2 days or so. Electrical powertrain's taken a bit of a hit. Aside from that, obviously we do need a bit of sand. But body's fine, and obviously just need to charge the battery, and that's just under half. So yeah, made it to Harbron Town from City Southwest with anywhere between 99 and 66 tons, I guess, of load kind of thing. What's the average? I don't know, somewhere between that anyway. But there we go, just charged up the battery there. That was nice and quick. I would really love, as I've mentioned in my previous video on this thing, if they simulated a slightly slower or significantly slower charge time, because that just seems to be too fast. But anyway, in the interest of getting this thing moving, we have charged up the battery. I'm not going to touch the wheel damage or electrical powertrain damage. I'm not going to repair those. So it's $1,900 to charge the battery up about halfway, or about 60%, and fill it full of sand, and we left the wallet inside, of course, so we need that. We need to come back outside here, insert the wallet into the old cash register, and pay the bill. So there we go, almost $2,000, and we've got full battery charge, and yeah, all right, so very good. We've filled up the sand as well, so we're good to go. Got a bit of wheel damage, but that's fine. Now, I'm not too sure how we're gonna go trying to connect this train, because that looks really skewed, that those carriages. So late afternoon, let's get this thing moving, see if we can't get this thing connected up. We'll back out, and then we'll head over there towards the station office. We'll park up for the night, and we'll go ahead and end day two, I guess. So let's try and get this train connected back up first. So let's do that. Okay, unfortunately, I can see the problem already. We cannot couple this train because we unfortunately have misaligned the couplers and the brakes are jammed on hard with on the passenger wagons, and there's no way to release the brakes because there's no like brake release, and I cannot reach the brake hoses across to connect them either. So that's great, we're basically stuck at the moment. Okay, well, the only thing I can try and do, I guess, is to try and shove these passenger wagons with the micro shunter with their brakes on, but I don't know how far I'm gonna get. I guess we'll have to try that because I've tried these brake hose connections about a million times and unfortunately it's not looking good. So yeah, let's try and shove this thing, I guess, and see how we go. Oh, that's not looking good. Let's try with the sand. We are making a bit of progress actually, but I shudder to think the damage we're doing to the wheels right now. Nope. We can't have that. Well, this is a little bit embarrassing. I've had to summon a DM3 from the roundhouse, and I'm just shoving these passenger wagons with their brakes hard applied, and the old DM3 is doing the job, I tell ya. It's, DM3 never lets us down. I'm going to move these passenger wagons back out to a straight section of track, and then we'll be able to couple the micro shunter up once again. So just bear with me while I do this. I love the DM3. Check out card up above if you want to see me driving this DM3 on a episode somewhere, and hopefully you'll enjoy that. I love this thing, never lets me down. So I can couple now, so that's awesome. All right, I'm not gonna waste too much more time now. I'm gonna head to the station office here in Harbour and Town, and we'll park up for the night, and we'll do a little bit of an outro for day two, and then we'll get ready for day three tomorrow. Okay, just managed to stop right outside the station office there, just in front of this level crossing. Yep. So yeah, that's basically the end of day two, folks. Just as I was hoping, we have made it to Harbour and Town, end of day two. We've done quite a bit of journeying so far. Day one obviously went from City Southwest over to Reginald's Garage. We did lose a carriage. But then, yeah, day two today, we continued on from Reginald's Garage and made it to Harbour and Town, which is where we are right now with our two carriages. Two carriages seems to be a comfortable kind of ratio or mix between challenge and speed, because I don't want to just crawl along either, but I don't want it to just be a milk run either. I want to obviously have a little bit of challenge in this whole thing. So yeah, managed to fully charge our battery now at the end of day two. And so we're ready again, once again, for day three. So we'll head over to the station office and we'll settle in for the evening. Tonight, thankfully, we get to sleep on the sofa and not on the floor of the actual micro shunter. Yay! Right, so here we are in the station office, and yep, it's 8 p.m. So nice little end to the evening there, end of day two, like I mentioned just now. So yeah, so far we've started off at City Southwest on this journey. Day one, we came down Sawmill, made our way across, and obviously ran into a few issues here. We had to drop a carriage. Well, I made that decision. Spent the night at Reginald's Siding there, Reginald's Garage, and obviously just had the two carriages connected at that point. And beginning of day two, we continued from Reginald's Garage all the way down across Eastwood towards Harbour and Town, which is where we are now. So basically, in 2 days, two in-game days, we've managed to make it from one end of the map across to the other, all the way from City Southwest all the way down to Harbour and Town. So I guess from here, obviously day three tomorrow morning, we'll be heading up these steep hills with our two carriages. Hopefully it doesn't rain. If it does, then we're pretty screwed actually. But yeah, hopefully the weather holds out. We'll be heading up. I might actually just hang a left here. Our target is going to be a food factory in town tomorrow, our destination. So I'm hoping we can actually make it to Food Factory in Town within a day. I might actually have an early start. I don't think we're going to go up this way like this, because that's just going to add more time going past Iron Ore Mine East like that. So I'm going to hang a left, I think, do the loop de loop and go to Food Factory in town tomorrow. Hopefully we can make it. Not too sure. We might have to camp out if we can't make it. But yep, that will remain to be seen. I think if we start at something like 4 a.m. or 5 a.m. in the morning, if I tuck in nice and early, 8 p.m. right now in game, and we make a nice 5 a.m. start, even if we're going in the night for a bit, we have to get along. We have to get on the way, even if before the sun rises, because we've got a long way to go. And there's some crazy hills along the way as we head north tomorrow as well. So it's not going to be an easy run. But yes, anyway, thank you so much if you've been watching this far. And yep, the video shall continue into day 3 tomorrow. There's our trusty little train with our trusty little Micro Shunter just waiting for us. She hasn't given up. She hasn't broken down. We'll just have to see if she can continue to haul us around the map, I guess, won't we? So I'll find this sofa. It's around here somewhere. Whoops, why am I going there? Actually, just thought I'd quickly check the weather before I forget, and it's looking good for 3 a.m. tomorrow morning. It's going to be nice and clear and sunny, which is great, because if there is rain, this thing's only rated for about 50 ton upper hill in the rain, upper 2% hill, and these are at least 2% here. So yeah, we can't have rain tomorrow morning. We have to leave early and go past those hills while the sun's still out, well, while the weather's still good. Anyway, catch you all in day 3 tomorrow. Right, good morning folks, and it's bright early in the morning. It's 4 a.m. Just after 4 a.m. in the morning, and we've got a lot of ground to cover today, so that's why I thought I'd get up a little bit early in the game, just before the sun rises, and we'll make our way out of here because we've got a lot of hill climbing to do this morning. The hills are going to be pretty relentless on our way to Food Factory, which is our target for today. So yeah, the hills coming out of Harbour and Town right there are just going to be atrocious. So see how we go. We're gonna have to keep the throttle on full probably for the majority of the trip today. Thankfully the weather is going to hold out for us from the looks of it, and it's not going to rain until probably 6 p.m. from the looks, but we'll be more or less out of here by that time and up these hills and gone by then. So without further ado, let's head on out. I think I'm going to take the shortcut to Food Factory in town. That means turning left here and do that little loop. I'm not going to come all the way up and do that iron ore mine east route there. Just gonna go across here like this. So, and even then that's gonna take probably forever to do anyway. So okay, let's head on out to the old trusty little Micro Shunter and get this thing moving. Going to have to use some lighting this morning because it's still quite dark. So thankfully we have charged the battery up full, so we don't have an issue in that regard. But I reckon we're going to take a real dent out of the battery today with all these hill climbs ahead of us. It's probably going to be day one kind of hill climbing, I think, today. Day two was actually quite pretty kind to us. But yeah, we'll see how we go today for day three. But I've got the feeling that our battery is going to be well below halfway by the time we reach Food Factory today. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it anyway. For the moment, just going to focus on getting out of here, out of Harbour and Town, and making our way out and start heading north, basically. So, yep, that's the plan. Sun's actually starting to come up now, but I've got the headlights on, as you can see here, just for the moment. So, burning a bit of battery, but got the throttle on full. I'm trying to keep the speed up because very shortly, as we make our way over to the left here on this left-hand curve, we're going to be encountering some fairly nasty hills, and those hills are going to last for quite a bit of time. So if I can keep as much momentum up as possible, that's going to help us, well, hopefully make shorter work of getting up these inclines. But yeah, make no mistake, it's going to be a bit of a grind today again, unfortunately folks. It's not going to be day two, it's going to be more like day one all over again. But the main thing is I'm just hoping we can retain enough battery charge to make it to Food Factory, because if we can't, then that's going to be a big problem. Alright, so here's the first of the hills. It's a plus 1.4% and already can hear the electric motors beginning to kind of wind down, even on full throttle. Unfortunately, yeah, they're no match for these hills. So yeah, the train's being kind of dragged back. Gravity is getting the better of us right now, but the amps should begin to increase. It's actually coming up to 6 a.m. right now, so yeah, we've been burning a bit of time. We're coming up to 100 amps there, so as this thing slows down, the amps ramp up, and then the temperatures start to ramp up as well, so that's fairly usual for this thing. We are rated for about 100 tons going up a grade in the dry, so we are okay. We've only got about 60 odd ton behind us, so we're gonna slow down, but we're not gonna stall. It's just gonna get really slow, that's all. Probably get down to about 5k an hour or so. Yes, but I'm just gonna have to babysit this thing for a little while, and yeah, once again, I'm not gonna put you all through the pain of sitting through the entire journey like this. I'll check in with you here and there as we continue our run north. And yes, we'll check in with you again very shortly. Well, the sun is well and truly out now, and we've just been continuing to trudge our way northward, day three, as we head towards Food Factory and town, leaving Harbour and town in the distance behind us, well and truly out of sight now. But yes, this thing is very much slowing to a halt almost, but not quite. It's actually got quite a bit of torque, but unfortunately it does slow down quite a lot before it can deliver that torque. So we're coming up to about 8 o'clock in the morning right now. And yeah, it's just, we've been encountering a few tunnels. You can see here our current position on the map. We've got a few more hills in front of us as we continue northward, but we do have a few level sections as well here and there, so we are going to pick up a bit of speed as we go, but there's going to be a lot of hills for the most part as well. So you can see there our amps right now are almost at 200, so we are really pushing this thing hard right now, and the traction motor temps are rising as well to about 90 degrees, so they're getting toasty as well. So yeah, don't want to we're down to just over 5 kilometers an hour with this thing, so yes, taking a bit of a dent out of the battery as well, as you would have seen there. So we're down to about 3/4 on the old battery almost. We're just above the 3/4 mark. We are increasing a bit of speed now though, so hopefully we'll be able to gain a bit of speed shortly. But yeah, it's just going to be a bit of teeter-tottering, I think, going slow, going fast today. So yeah, once we get out of the yellow zone of those amps, which we just have, our motor temps should start to reduce back down as well, which I think they already are from the looks of things. So that's good, as we pick up speed once again. And obviously the other issue is we're going to try not to go too fast as we pick up speed as well, because we don't want to ruin the motors. So yeah, I'm going to try and keep it under about 40, as I've been mentioning so far during this trip. So we've got another speed sign up ahead, and that's telling us that there's more of a incline from what I just saw there. Let's have another look actually. Yeah. Yep, that is more of an incline right there. So thankfully it's only a 0.8% grade, so not too bad. We've been nursing a few 2% grades just now, so, or 2% plus kind of thing. So yeah, 0.8% is not too bad, but once we get onto the level, it's going to be even better. So we'll just continue on. And yeah, hopefully next time I check in with you, we'll be going a little bit faster as well. Still some graphical artifacts there, as you can see on the tracks in these tunnel entrances, which they haven't managed to clean up yet. Anyway, I'll catch you all in just a moment. going through ever more tunnels lately. And yes, there's not really much to report. It's just a very slow micro shunter, but it's doing the job and it's not quitting just yet. So there's something slightly therapeutic about driving this thing. All you really need to worry about is just keeping the battery charge at a healthy level, and then otherwise you just put the throttle on and let this thing go. But yeah, unfortunately I can't see how you'd do any like realistic or actual hauling jobs with this thing, simply because it just can't really haul that much load, I guess, at the end of the day. It's only really good for about 100 ton going up 2% grade, and that's in the dry. So coming up to about 10 o'clock now, and you can see here we've made a bit of progress on the map. Trying to save the old battery by turning off the headlights as much as possible, but I'm using them now and again. But yes, not much to report otherwise as we continue our way northward towards Food Factory. And I really do hope that we start to pick up some speed soon, because I want to get this thing moving. We've been going too slow for too long now. So I'm hoping and praying for some level track. And I know that we'll reach it shortly. And then before you know it, we'll have too much momentum and we'll have to be using the brakes. But for the moment, it's just a bit of a slow grind. But it's not going to last too much longer, I'm sure. I'm trying to stay positive, in case you can't tell. Okay, so we've tipped just below 3/4 now on the battery, so we've kind of made a good distance as we continue northward towards Food Factory. And I think finally we're beginning to hit the level section of the track, so that's good. I can hear the motor's speeding up, so I'm going to get off the throttle. I'm just going to turn some of these lights off. I'll stick to the dial lights because I think that's fine. And I think, hooray, I think we're actually starting to speed up now, finally, this morning. And yeah, just as well, because our battery has really taken a huge hit this morning as well. So yeah, we're coming up. It's going to be midday soon as well. So yeah, it's just as well that we got an early start this morning too. So it's 50k now limit and increasing. So yeah, I'm just getting off the throttle now for the first time in since we left Harbour and Town. We've been going full throttle this entire time, so don't need full throttle just now though, because we are on level track and possibly even starting to go downhill. So I'm really thankful for that. And the birds are singing, the weather's good. There's a lot to be thankful for as we continue our journey northward this morning. We are late morning right now. But yeah, hopefully we can claw back a little bit of progress and distance now, and make up some distance with this speed. Save a bit of battery. I'm happiest when we're doing at least 20k an hour plus. Excellent. All right, I think we're starting to kind of slow down a bit, but you can see there on the map that we are in the level section. Unfortunately, there are more grades in front of us very shortly, but at least we're on the level section for now, so we'll make the most of this momentum. You know what, I'm just going to go full throttle now, coming up to 11 o'clock in the morning. So soon it's going to be midday, and then we'll be well and truly into the afternoon. So I want to try and keep as much momentum going as we can. We're only pulling about 50 amps, so really the difference between half throttle and full throttle is only in the tens of amps, as you can see there. So yeah, we're not going to be using too much battery at full throttle anyway right now, as long as the speed stays up. It's only when they start to slow down, that's when the battery really takes a hit, when the amps start to increase like that. But anyway, I'll just play with the throttle a little bit there. We're back to idle now, and it seems to be holding its speed. So yeah, we must be going down a slight downhill, I think. Potentially. Right, okay, well, I'll keep this thing moving, and I'll check in with you again, once again, in just a few moments. Been making some good progress lately. well and truly on some level sections at the moment, if not some downhill, so making some good progress as we continue ever north. We do have a junction coming up soon. I just need to make sure that we head off to the right hand side and not over the bridge that you can see there. There's a tunnel right there. We want to make sure we go through that tunnel, otherwise we'll be going in the wrong direction. So if we have a quick look at the map, you can see our current location, and we are snaking our way up ever closer to Food Factory. We'll be passing over Goods Factory in town soon, and unfortunately as we do that we're going to be encountering some more hills, some more uphills. So yeah, anyway, I must say that we are doing okay so far, and the weather's been kind to us, so I guess the weather's going to be okay for most of today, and we'll be into day 4 tomorrow, and we'll have to see what the weather's like once we reach Food Factory in town. We may find that the weather will take a turn for the worst maybe on day 4, but not going to jinx anything. We'll just have to wait and see how that goes, but at least we're making some good progress right now, so we'll keep this momentum going as we head on off to the right hand side here. 60k an hour limit, we're not doing that anytime soon, and we've got this more level ground, so that's good. Let's go through this tunnel here, get the headlight going. That horn always gets me. Yep, so we're basically on bang on midday right now, and this is where we are on the map. So made some good progress today even with all these hills. We're about halfway or just over halfway to Food Factory, and we're halfway through the day, being that it's midday as well. So I think starting as early as we did today was a good idea, but even so we're going to be chasing the sun, I think, from all indications right now, so can't afford to slow down. We'll just keep it going. And I did spot a castle around here just before, and there it is there, look at that. I haven't actually gotten up close and personal to that castle in Derail Valley yet, maybe one day. But for the moment, we've just got to keep this thing moving, because we have to try and make Food Factory before it gets too dark. But I've got the feeling it's going to be well and truly sunset, if not darkness, by the time we reach Food Factory. But that's going to be the next place that we're going to charge this thing, because battery wise we're actually not doing too badly. But yeah, we've got some more inclines coming up, and we're just below 3/4 on the battery there, and that looks like that was a 1.2% uphill. So yeah, unfortunately our run of good speed, good momentum is coming to an end once again. But I can't really complain too much, because we've had some good sections there where we've kept the speed up. So gonna slow down once again, and that, looking at my map, I think that's a 1.4% grade actually, and I think we're gonna be hitting some more level ground in just a moment after that. But for the moment we've got this grade section once more. Interesting landscape in Derail Valley in this section of the map. Very rocky but also very wooded as well. I can feel the train slowing down even more. I think we're going to be down in the sub 10s speed wise in just a moment. Ooh, okay, what's going on here? Uh-oh, this is not good. We're really slowing down now. What have we done? The brakes are not on, are they? Nope, brakes are off. Yep, we're up to 200 amps now. It's gonna get nice and toasty. We're down to 5k's an hour, so that's not good. Hopefully just a short-lived kind of incline. Not sure what's going on. I didn't think we were going up such a big hill, but apparently this is a fairly gnarly incline from the looks of things. Doesn't really look like it from the outside, but there you go. Ah, the poor old Micro Shunter, what can I say? We're really giving this thing a run for its money, aren't we? Just have a quick peek outside like this. Yeah, I guess there is a bit of a... yeah, okay. Coming out of the tunnel was a bit of a downhill, but then it sort of went uphill quite sharply there. But we're starting to speed up once again, so it's not too bad. Down to 3/4 on the old battery there. This kind of running really chews the battery up. Okay, well, we're accelerating once again, so just teeter-tottering on the old speed there once again. We'll keep it moving. We should start to see the lights or the smoke of Goods Factory very soon. Goods Factory in town. And unfortunately, as mentioned before, once we pass the overpass of Goods Factory, there's going to be more hills. But hooray, that's another level speed sign there. It's telling us that we've got level once again. So we should start to speed up again as we get close to Goods Factory in town. So hopefully we'll pick that momentum up. Getting down to about half on the battery now, and if I'm not wrong, I think this will be where we'll start to see Goods Factory in town finally. Yes, there it is. There's the chimney, that telltale chimney that I've seen more than a few times now playing this game. That lets us know that Goods Factory in town is in sight. So that's always good. Unfortunately, immediately after that bridge, you can almost see it in the distance. There's a really sharp incline, so yeah, hooray. For the moment though, we're going to be picking up a bit of speed as we go over this bridge, over these bridges. There's two of them, so we'll keep the momentum going, but yeah, soon we'll be slowing way down once again. I must say, it's been fairly uneventful today, day three, so I guess that's a good thing in some ways, because you don't want problems either. We'll just have to see how we go once we get to Food Factory in town. And the weather's been really kind to us, so that's also been good as well. So there you go, there's our first taste of the incline. It's a 0.6% grade. Ah, can't really catch a break sometimes, can we? There's Goods Factory in the background below us, and we're starting to slow down already. There's that crazy incline right there. You can see that it kind of goes level, and then right about here it just starts going up and becomes quite gnarly indeed. So yeah, we've got that in front of us. So many inclines in this region of Derail Valley's map, isn't it? There's just leaving Harbour and Town, it's just so treacherous. It's a good little run to test these locomotives, but man, does it get really slow sometimes, especially with this little Micro Shunter. I couldn't think of anything not suited to this task. Anything else not suited to this task aside from this thing. Really, this is an emergency tow vehicle. It's not meant to be doing these long distance journeys with these with all these loads behind it, but anyway, I like to do these crazy things sometimes, I guess. And really great to have you along for the ride. If you're still watching, I really appreciate it. It's been very uneventful, I realize, like I mentioned already. Today at least, day three. Day three has been a little bit uneventful, but all the same, we've made some fairly reasonable progress as well, so that's always good. We are racing the sun though. It's gonna be, well, it is already afternoon, and we've just been mired by all these inclines, unfortunately. So I'm doing my best, doing my level best to keep this thing moving. Got the throttle at full, and here is the uphill, so yay. Yep, this is one of them 200 amp inclines, unfortunately. So we are putting the battery to the test again. We're going to start cooking the motors soon if this keeps up as well. Such a grind sometimes with this thing. It just has such low speed torque, but that's where the torque happens, unfortunately, at low speeds. So you kind of have to be patient with this thing and just enjoy the scenery. That's all you can really do. Just watch the scenery slowly, ever so slowly, grind past you. And it, yeah, the time is really getting on. It's 3 o'clock now in the afternoon, actually. So yeah, and we're only just passing Goods Factory now. So yes, there's not much else we can do. Just keep that throttle fully open. I'm actually trying to suss out the electrical charging bay down that Goods Factory, but I think it's, hang on, motor's getting nice and warm. Yep, just as expected. Yeah, I think the servicing bay is within the shed, engine shed, so it's not really visible from the outside, unfortunately. Just within that shed, I believe. But anyway, we can't get down there right now to Goods Factory because that's on a completely different level. We just have to keep on pushing to Food Factory, and hopefully we can make it with the amount of charge we've got. We've got just over half battery, and this is where we are on the map, so yeah, we'll just have to keep it moving. And I'm definitely going to take that left-hand turn to go to Food Factory. I'm not going to mess around and try and make this journey any longer than it should be, I think, because It's quite a struggle as it is already, so mindful of time as well. Oh, but I can't get over how cute this little thing looks though. How could you? Look at that. How could you stay mad or even get mad at something like this? Now I'm just fooling around. I've decided to leave the cab and just see how fast this thing's actually going in comparison to walking speed. And as you can see, I'm pretty much walking at the same speed as what this thing's currently doing. It's a bit disappointing, isn't it? What I might do is, okay, need to actually change those points. So let's get back inside and sort that out, actually. So just confirming, we do have to go left here, and it's currently set to take us off to the right, which is not good. But it looks like, I think we've got level ground over to the left and a hill over to the right. So just as well, we are actually going to the left. So we should start to pick up some speed soon. And let me just flip that over. There we go. Excellent. Right, we're on track. Let's resume with the craziness. I could have just ran up to the switch, I realize, and just flipped it over manually. But no, well, there you go. Sun's going down as we barrel ever closer to Food Factory, and just like I thought, like I've been saying today on day three, it really is a race against the sun right now. As the sun starts to go down over the valley, we still need to make our way all the way down and around this little loop section right here as we continue on to Food Factory. So yes, yeah, basically need to do that little loop-de-loop now, and then we'll be pretty much upon Food Factory. Let's put the brakes on a little bit harder because I'm actually going a little bit too fast here for my own comfort. I don't want to cause any issues, because if we blow up a traction motor now, we're basically up the creek without a paddle. So I actually thought as well that I probably should have attached another one of these to the train somewhere, just as a spare little micro shunter in case something happens to this one, but it's way too late for that now. The other thing I could have done as well was probably picked up a DE2 along the way somewhere, and maybe use that as a bit of a helper going up some of these hills, but again, so far, been managing just with the little micro shunter on its own. This is quite a decent downhill, actually. This section here is like minus 1.6, I think it was, or something in along those lines. So, gonna have to keep the brakes on here quite hard. Oops, not that hard. Oops. Okay, full throttle, come on. Speed this thing back up. I really don't want to hold this thing up when it could be going a lot quicker right now, especially given all these little downhill sections, so make the most of them and try and make our way to Food Factory in Town ASAP, because the way it's going, I have a feeling it's going to be well dark by the time we get there. So let's get back up to about 30k an hour if we can in that region between 30 and 40, and I'll be happy again. Yep. Gonna need the brakes just a little bit. Okay, so yep, we've got to be down there, and we're gonna be down there in just a moment. The proper way, not falling down there, but actually taking the loop. Just try and manage the speed the best I can here. Keep it above 30. Looks like it's coming up to about 8 p.m. right now as well, so yeah, it's getting a little bit late. There's Food Factory! It's in sight. Excellent. Alright, that's where we need to be, folks, to finish off day 3. So somehow we are making it. I'm so glad that this day is finishing off at a much faster pace than it started, that's for sure. It really was a grind today. I'm hoping that tomorrow is not going to be like that. Day 4 should be the last day and we'll be done with this run around the map in this micro shunter. So basically it would have taken us 4 in-game days is what I'm estimating. As long as we can keep the pace up. That run from Food Factory tomorrow got some hills coming out of there, but majority of the run is going to be level ground, so I'm hoping that it's going to be a nice easy one. Okay, alright, well I'll keep this thing going. We are moving along at quite a nice pace right now, so I just want to keep the speed up, so I'll keep nursing this thing for another few moments and I'll be back in touch with you shortly. Okay, so it's coming up to almost 10 p.m. in the evening. It's 9:30 at the moment. So well and truly evening time, but we are getting closer and closer to Food Factory with every moment that goes by. So Food Factory is just visible there over to the left-hand side. And it won't be long now. We'll actually be within the limits of Food Factory. And what I'm thinking of doing is we'll just pull into the platforms and we'll call it a night, do a real quick summary, and then yeah, tomorrow morning in the game we'll be doing a dash probably down the middle of the map kind of thing. Bit of a shortcut I think I'll take to City Southwest, where we began this entire journey. So not far now from Food Factory. We'll be there in just a moment. I'm just ready on the comms radio in case there's any points I need to flip over. Gonna have a quick look actually, just to see where the I think the platforms are in B and C potentially, and then looks like we've got the station office nearby as well. But also one thing I forgot to mention is in the morning, I'm not going to do it tonight, but in the morning I'll need to charge the battery up again for this thing, because main batteries come down quite a bit. So Yeah, I think that where that green spanner is where the engine shed with the servicing bay is. So, yes. Anyway, it's 10 p.m. So the sooner we get this thing parked up for the night, the better. And we'll deal with all that other stuff in the morning. Right, so just heading towards the platform sidings now. This is Food Factory proper. Got the station office on the right-hand side there, just near that street lamp. And we'll be at the platforms in just a moment. We'll do a bit of a quick summary and then we'll call it for the night. And then what we'll have to do is, yeah, as I mentioned, in the morning we'll do a bit of a charge up on the batteries and then we won't waste any time getting out of here on the last leg of our journey. So, yeah, as slow as it has been at times, it's actually coming to a conclusion in some ways. And, yeah, it's a little bit sad as well. But anyway, I guess we must have been having fun. Well, I've been having a bit of fun. Hopefully you've been having fun. Okay, I'm gonna go off to the left from the looks of it. Actually, I should have gone probably to the right hand side here, I was thinking. That's fine, there's platforms all over the place. I'm just going to the inner platform where we'll park up for the night. And then once we're parked up, we'll be able to do a quick bit of a summary for today. Overall, was a bit of a fast finish for day three, I think you'll agree. It was a slow start though, but yeah, even starting at like 4 a.m. or whatever it was in the morning, still ended up finishing quite late. So sometimes, well, with this micro shunter, you can't hang around. Well, you need all the time you can get because it's slow, but we love it, don't we? Okay, so battery power there, you can see is just over 1/4, just between the quarter and 2/4 mark there. And yeah, I think we can call it a night now. And what I'll do is, I just realized I could have actually been using this lantern this whole time within the cab as well and saved the cab lights. That probably would have saved a little bit of the main battery. That's annoying. I'll have to keep that in mind for tomorrow if we end up traveling in the evening again. But it's possible that we'll make it to City Southwest before nightfall tomorrow if we start early again. Not too sure, but see how we go anyway. All right, that's enough, I think. Let's call it a night and yeah, we'll head back to the station office. Okay, so to wrap up day three, we've ended up here at Food Factory as we wanted to. We did leave Harbour and Town nice and early in the morning and we did a massive grind up those hills, didn't we? So yes, we did make it in the end and it's 11:30 in the evening. So I think now's pretty much a good enough time to call it quits for the night at least. And then tomorrow morning, what I'm thinking of doing is once we charge up the batteries, we'll go ahead and make our way from here down to City Southwest to finish off this run. And it's still going to be technically around the map. I think the sofa's around here somewhere for me to have a bit of a sleep in tonight, which is good. But yes, so tomorrow morning we've got some hills. I'm not going to go around this way. I think it's going to be probably a bit long, just based off how slow this thing is as well and how long this video will end up being. I'm going to come down this way like this. And that's mostly level run, actually. So we're going to take just a little bit of a shortcut. Not that much of a shortcut. We're still going around the map. So yeah, that's the plan at least for tomorrow. So I'm not going to come around this way because it's just going to add too much time to journey. And it's going to be quite a long journey. So there's some crazy hills right around here. Some really gnarly uphill sections. But after that, it's going to be mostly level ground, I believe. There's going to be a few hills here and there, but yeah, really not that much. And it looks like the weather's going to be kind to us, so it looks like there's not much rain anymore. So I was kind of dreading and panicking, you know, whilst I was making this video. Are we going to hit some bad hills on these grades? Sorry, some bad weather. But yeah, it looks like it's going to be a fairly easy run. So yeah, we managed to get out of Harbour and Town today with some good weather too, so that's good. Okay, it's coming up to midnight now in the game, so yeah, time to call it. and I'll catch you guys in the morning, and we'll wrap this thing up. I think it's going to be the last day, and I think we'll finish well before nightfall tomorrow, so yay. Okay folks, so it's nice and early in the morning once again. Sun is only just starting to make its way up in the valley. We are looking at basically 5:30 a.m. start this morning for day 4 of this journey around the entire map. And so we've ended up here at Food Factory, and this morning we'll be tackling some rather challenging hills, but then we've got a shortcut section which is mostly level, which will be our last quick leg to City Southwest, which is where we started from on this really long journey. So yes, might as well get started without further ado. You can hear the wildlife just going a little bit crazy this morning. All right, so let's make our way back to the platforms where we left our trusty little micro shunter, and we shall start our journey, our return journey now to City Southwest. So I think we're going to need some lights this morning. And one thing we do need to do as well is just charge the battery up, because the battery is looking a little bit low there. We're down to around a quarter or so, or basically just above one quarter. So we'll get this thing moving. I'll move it into the manual servicing section of this map, which is not far away, just over to the right hand side from where we are now. And yeah, can see there it's 5:45 now in the morning, as per that station clock there. So yeah, let's go charge this battery up and get this thing moving. Can see there the sun's really reflecting off those buildings. That there is basically where the electrical charging station is, within that little shed right over there. So we just need to pull forward here and then back up into that shed once we change these points over. So I'll just do that quickly now and rejoin with you. Okay, so just backing in now folks, into the engine shed, or servicing shed I guess you'd call it. What I'm going to do though first is I'm going to drop off these wagons, because I just realized as well, because we are backing in, these two wagons behind us, they're too long. Oh, I just saw something run past. What was that? Oh, look at that. It's a little cat. Oh, God. He just made it. He almost got run over, the poor little guy. He just ran between the engine and the first carriage there. What are you doing, little fellow? You almost got run over. Ah, look at him. Look how cute he is. Little tabby. Aww. Oh. I think he's just made a bit of a mess and he's cleaning up. Okay, well, you know, as you do. Having a little stretch now, and on with the day. Ah, that's cute, isn't it? Okay, so what was I saying? We need to basically disconnect these carriages, because they are too long to fit. Once we back into the engine shed, we're not going to be able to reach the charging station with the engine all the way on the front. So hopefully that makes sense. I'm just going to drain the air out to apply the brakes there on those carriages. And then we'll basically pull into the engine shed now. Whoop. So let's do that. Okay, so we're just listening out for the little beep that will tell us that we are in range of the charging station, and I think I've put the brakes on a little bit too aggressively here. Ah, come on, keep rolling. Waiting for that ding. Oh no, don't tell me, come on. Don't make me start this thing up again. Yeah, there we go, there's that ding. Okay, just made it. Just applied the brakes slightly too aggressively, but was fine in the end. All right, so let's get this thing charged up. And where's this charging port? There it is. Excellent. Right, so we're down to about a quarter, just above a quarter of battery charge at the moment. So this is going to be our last recharging of this video. Okay, day 4. So far we've had to charge only twice to make it more or less around the map. So that's not too bad for this little shunter, isn't it? But yeah, I must say the charging costs aren't exactly small either. Look at that, it's $1,700 worth of electricity. You can see there we've got some wheel damage and we've got a little bit of sand that's depleted from sand usage, but should be fine. Not going to bother with doing any repairs. Got some electrical powertrain damage as well, but yes, I'm not going to do any of those other repairs or replenish the sand. I'm just going to top up the battery and leave it at that. So I just need to scoot on inside the loco to get the wallet, because the wallet was in there. Need the wallet. Right, there we go. So 1729 there for electricity costs. And we have, ladies and gentlemen, a full load or full charge of batteries once again. That will easily take us to City Southwest today. And what am I doing? Need to turn the electrics on first. Oop. Just being a bit aggressive here. Just want to get this thing moving already. We'll make it back over to those wagons, those carriages on our left there. Recouple, and then we'll be on our way. And unfortunately, we've got a really gnarly set of hills right in front of us as soon as we leave this place. But yeah, weather's looking okay so far. Hopefully the weather holds, because we don't want any wet rails as we start climbing these hills. That's the last thing we want. I must say the weather's been really kind to us so far in this journey. So hopefully the weather holds out, because we've got some hills in front of us and we don't want these wet rails to kind of spoil the party here, because we've got a bit of load as well, and this is only a very small micro shunter and we're already above the weight limit for it. So I can't imagine how it's going to go in the rain as well. So hopefully the weather holds up and we get a nice continuation of the sunny days that we've been seeing for the most part. So we'll see how we go, and yeah, away we go out of Food Factory in town over to City Southwest, the last leg of this journey. And so, as I was saying, just past this tunnel we've got our first set of gnarly inclines for the day, but then once we get over them, we should be on level ground for the most part for the rest of today's trip. So it's just getting through this little section here, and it probably doesn't look like much to look at, but I'll show you in just a moment. Towards the end, you can see there it says already 2.1% grade. Basically in this little area here, you've got a whole bunch of inclines. Then it's all level ground after that. So if we have a look at the tracks here, you'll see that right around there, the track just like goes completely vertical almost. It's a bit of an exaggeration, but you'll see in a second. Listen for the change in the motor hum. Yep, and we've actually just gone up the hill with the loco. Yep, and you can now hear the locomotive starting to slow down. And there it goes. We are basically, oh no, maybe this hill is too much. Oh god, 200 amps. Let's get the sand on just in case. Looks like we don't need the sand. Oh, no. I think the wheels are starting to spin. Yep. Yep, the wheels are spinning. Let's, oh no, let's do something about that. The sand, the sand. Oh, the sand's doing nothing. No, I think we're going to stall this train right now, because we are on this hill and we're still spinning the wheels. Ooh, 200 amps plus. We are really going to cook the electric motors if we keep this up. This is the hill that might actually kill us. I'm so glad we got rid of that extra carriage, because we probably wouldn't be able to do this otherwise. This is going to be a long, slow struggle once again. Now, if the rails were wet and it was raining right now, we'd be in so much more trouble as well. But we'll just have to keep this thing moving, and hopefully we don't run into any issues. Yeah, there's not much else we can do right now. We'll just have to getting some temperature warning bells as well for the traction motors. Yep, they're right on about 100 degrees there. We are really cooking it. I'm gonna have to reduce the throttle just a little bit, just to bring those temps down on the motor, or motors, because we're right on the red line of the traction motor temperatures as well, so not good, not a good start. It's 8:30 in the morning as well, so I'm just gonna have to keep grinding away here just for a few moments, and hopefully we'll be over this hill in just a moment or two, and then we'll be back on level ground. But yeah, for the moment we've just got a little bit of incline ahead of us, unfortunately. And you'll know that I actually ran into the same issue with the steam shunter when I went around the map with that one as well. I'll put a card up above for the steam shunter if you want to check out the video where I went around the map with it. It looks like it's happier with full throttle once again, so I'm just gonna... I've turned the sand off as well, and thankfully that seems to be going okay. So we'll keep on trudging, and we should be over this incline very, very shortly. And then we'll be back on more or less level ground, and we'll be able to pick up a bit of speed. Maybe we'll get some downhill sections as well, and really get the speed going. So, yeah. It's not gonna be a long and grinding day like yesterday was in the game, so I'm thankful for that. Well, unfortunately, it looks like the weather has kicked in. So, yes. The weather gods, I think, are finally not smiling down on us anymore. They've decided to make the last day of this trip a wet and rainy kind of affair. So, we'll see how this goes anyway. I think we're more or less out of the woods when it comes to inclines. We do have a bit of an incline still that we're nursing, but it's looking a lot better. And even with the rain, I don't have my sander on, so we'll just keep this thing moving. And hopefully the rain doesn't get too much worse. Just having a bit of a look up at the sky here. It does look a bit cloudy and looks a bit ominous, but there's still patches of blue here and there. So fingers crossed, and hopefully we see some sunny skies again soon. Well, folks, seems like I spoke way too soon there. Looks like we've got all manner of thunder and lightning and rain coming down right now. Yes, it's going to be one of those days, I think, in the game. Last day, and it's pouring down. The weather couldn't hold out any longer, so hopefully this doesn't cause any issues for our return back to City Southwest. Just going to have to weather the storm, as it were. So, fingers crossed, that's all we can really do. Problems here. Looks like we're getting some wheel spin because this got a bit of an incline here that's a little bit unrelenting, and this rain has ruined the rails, made them all wet. So really all we can do once again is apply the sand, maybe reduce the throttle a little bit, and just hope that we get into some level territory soon, because these inclines are really, really annoying. And we're pulling some serious amps right now as well, so just trying to keep track, keep the motor temperatures under control as well as we go. The wheel slip is a little bit unrelenting here. I'm gonna need to keep this sand going, because you can see here, the moment I turn off the sand, the wheels just start spinning. So this hill is really getting us right now. I don't know if we're going to be able to keep going like this. The rain just will not stop as well. So the rails are very wet and slippery, and we've still got inclines ahead of us. So I'm hoping it will all be over soon, and we'll be back to some sunny weather and level track. Okay, thankfully we're picking up a bit of speed now, so we're either on a level or we're going down a hill slightly, but this is very, very welcome, and hopefully this will set the pace for the rest of this run now. Look at that thunder just lighting up the end of that tunnel there. Talk about light at the end of the tunnel. Fog was really set in as well, and it's like you can hardly see what's over the edge of that cliff. It looks very treacherous indeed, doesn't it? What a way to finish off the last day of the trip. Just absolutely crazy weather. The Derail Valley weather gods are angry today. The good news is our run of momentum seems to be continuing, so hopefully the speed keeps up and we just keep on rolling through this bad weather. Right now I'm just babysitting the brakes and making sure that we don't overspeed. So our battery power is down to just over 3/4, and you can see here on the map we're making some good progress. We're well and truly on the level section of the map as we barrel on towards City Southwest now, our final destination for this video. So yes, once again, just on the brakes intermittently here, just to make sure that we're not overspeeding, because that can cause its own set of problems. Thankfully, we've seen the end of that weather now, and the birds are singing once again. So that's always good news. And it looks like we've put all of the hills behind us, because I've still just been babysitting these brakes for the most part over these past several minutes. So yes, happy to report that everything is going well for the moment. And turn off some lights here because we don't really need them. And for the most part, we are just coasting ever further towards City Southwest. Position wise, we are more than halfway down that little shortcut section, so soon we'll be upon a little junction which we'll just continue straight through, and then we're on the home straight, folks, towards City Southwest after that. So I think right now we're on track for like a, I don't know, 5 to 6 p.m. arrival, I guess. So we should be at City Southwest before nightfall, and we'll be wrapping this video up and wrapping the journey up. And what a journey it's been so far, isn't it? Can't believe we're coming to the pointy end of it already. In just a moment we'll be at the little viaduct or viaduct section, which will signal that we are pretty much done with this shortcut section of the map, and we'll be almost at the junction. You can see actually there's a body of water there on our right. So yes, very soon now, very soon we'll be at that little junction, that little Y junction, and then it's just that last home straight after that. And very happy with the fact that we're not having to accelerate right now, we're just off the throttle completely, and saving a whole bunch of battery, which is good. We've got the storms behind us, and we've got all the hills in the distance behind us as well. Here's that viaduct I was talking about. And it looks like I'm going to have to apply a bit of power now because losing a bit of momentum. So we must be coming up to a bit of a slightly hilly section here. Yep, we're definitely on a bit of a hill now. So basically back to full throttle and just struggling for the moment once again. But it won't be for very long. Once we're over this bridge, we're going to be back to coasting down a slight downhill once again. Almost there, folks. Almost there. We'll be right back. is at Y Junction. And then from here, I think it's 100 kilometer hour limit as we head on towards City Southwest. So home straight, as I've mentioned before, is just about to be entered. There's that 100k an hour limit sign that I think we just passed there on the right hand side. So once again, I'm gonna start babysitting this thing and making sure that it does not run away from us. Down to 3/4 battery now after all this time, coming up to I think what looks like 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and here we are on the map. So home straight now. Just having a quick look at where we came from. Looks like we've left the weather well and truly behind. It looks very ominous over there, doesn't it? From whence we came. But now into the sunshine, which is great. Just keep the speed in check. We'll be at City Southwest now in no time. Battery's been holding at 3/4 at the moment because really not using much power this whole time for many, many minutes now. We've just been coasting. So, yeah, not really much need to keep any throttle going. I've got a little bit on now, about halfway, but there it is. There's City Southwest. We've actually made it back here. And, yeah, it's the afternoon of day 4 in the game. So it's basically taken us about 4 in-game days to make our way back towards City Southwest. Looks like it's 4:30 in the afternoon now, so we're going to be here well before nightfall. And we'll park up at the platforms from where we began all those days ago in the game. And that's going to be it, folks. I can't believe it. We're actually here already. It seems like a long trip, but also a short trip. And kind of sad as well right now because it's all over. set these switches up so that we go to the platforms and not out of here, and not to the engine shed either. So this will take us straight into the platforms here at City Southwest, and this will mark the end of our journey. Weather's cleared up, which is great. We did get a little taste of that weather earlier though, didn't we? But I think overall, it could have been a lot worse. We could have had that bad weather earlier on when we were leaving Harbour and Town there. But thankfully we didn't. That was the beginning of day 3, I think, that one. So, yes. I think the weather's been very kind to us and we've kind of lucked out a little bit. Well, we've been quite lucky, I should say, on this trip. But alas, as we barrel on towards these platforms where we'll make our final stop, that will be the end, folks, of this journey. So we'll get ready on the brake here because we don't want to go right into the end of the platform. That is not ideal. Okay, that's it. Put these brakes on. Then once we stop, I'll put this handbrake on as well so that we're fixed in place. Okay. Alright, that's it. Just need a moment here. Yep, that's it. That's all she wrote. Handbrake on and call it. Get everything? Yep. Cool. Alright, let's get on out of here. There's that little shunter. That little micro shunter. I can't believe it's so tiny. And yeah, it's made the trip. So just walking back now to the station office and we'll do a bit of a summary and wrap this thing up. Yeah, I feel a little bit like that crying baby in the background there. I'm not sure if you can hear that, but yeah, it's all over. That's it. That's the trip done. So, that's it. We started off here, City Southwest, 4 in-game days ago. So day one was going down to Sawmill there. We made our way across. We dropped off one wagon, spent our first night there. Day two, made our way across to Harbour and Town, some treacherous little twisties. Some hills along the way, then we made our way to Harbour and Town. Next day, climbing some treacherous hills, day three, up towards Food Factory, more hills. This was a rather grinding section here, wasn't it, on day three? I think day three was the worst, going to Food Factory there. And then spent another night there, recharged the old batteries again. And yeah, we did recharge in Harbour and Town as well. And then made our way back to City Southwest in this little shortcut way. So more or less around the map, I guess you could say. We didn't quite go all the way around the fringes of the map. But yeah, we did get a nice taste of that weather today, didn't we, on the last day? And we only had to recharge twice. These hills here, coming out of Harbour and Town, were pretty bad. And I think if we had some bad weather here on day three, we would have been a lot worse, I think. So at least the weather held out on day three. That was good. But it was still a very long day, that one, wasn't it? From dawn to dusk. That was a bit of a journey, that one, on day three, I think you'll agree. With the old Micro Shunter. In comparison, day four today, we had a bit of weather, but we were able to keep moving. So, yeah, anyway, that's a bit of a summary of the trip. 6 p.m. now, and I think that's it. I'm really exhausted, folks. So, yes, thank you so much for watching. If you made it this far as well, really appreciate it. Please think about liking the video if you did like it. Comment if you feel like it as well. If you want to see anything different in the future, let me know what you thought about this video. Share the video as well if you like. Maybe you want me to do something different with the Micro Shunter in the future. I didn't obviously go the long way around, but I think you'll agree. We did quite a nice little run around the map with this thing, considering it's not meant to do what it was doing. Over these past 4 days, it was meant to just be an emergency tow vehicle, so I think it's done very well indeed given the circumstances. And yeah, I think it was good that we did drop that last wagon as well and go back to two carriages, because it probably wouldn't have made some of those hills otherwise, especially today. So yeah, anyway, I think I'll wrap this up here finally, and thank you once again. I really appreciate your support for the channel, and I'll catch you all in the next one.